Today, I want to introduce you to magnets and magnetic fields. Magnets are materials that have an invisible force that surrounds them and which allows them to attract or repel other materials. Here is a bunch of tiny metal filings. Let's see what happens when a magnet is introduced underneath. The small metal filings are suddenly attracted to the magnet. That invisible force drawing the filings to the magnet is called a magnetic field. We can even make out the shape of the magnetic field as we move the magnet away. If magnetic fields were visible, they would look something like this. Magnets, in other words, materials that produce magnetic fields, can be found in nature or can be constructed by people. But what causes a material to produce magnetic fields? Well, let's take a look inside this magnet. Here's an atom. See those little fellows moving around? Those are electrons. Let's take a closer look at them. Electrons are subatomic particles that have a negative charge. This means that an electron is a very small thing that has plenty of energy. They are everywhere. Electrons generate magnetic fields. But wait a minute, if electrons are everywhere, why isn't everything a magnet? Well, in some materials, electrons are not very active. This makes those materials seem non-magnetic. In other materials, electrons are very active and generate magnetic fields. But sometimes these electrons are positioned in opposite directions.
Oh no! Oops!
Causing the magnetic fields to cancel each other out. However, when many electrons are aligned, a magnetic field strong enough for us to observe its effects is created. A simple representation of what we've learned so far about electrons is turning an average screw into a magnet. We will need an iron screw, a common magnet, and a couple of paper clips for demonstration. Notice that the screw doesn't initially display any magnetic properties. Now all we have to do is begin to stroke the screw with the magnet in the same direction. What we are basically doing is causing the electrons in the screw to realign parallel to each other. Well, it's time to test the theory. If what we know about electrons is true, then this screw should be able to generate a magnetic field. And there it is! Another fact about electrons is that when they flow through a conductor, these electrons align in the same direction, creating a magnetic field. This is how electromagnets are created. To build an electromagnet, all you need is another screw, some copper wire, and a battery. We also will be using safety gloves to protect our hands from the electric current. We will use a couple of staples for demonstration purposes. The current will run through the copper wire. In other words, this is our conductor. Take the wire and wrap it around the screw as many times as you can, leaving a few inches of wire loose on both ends. The electrons in the current will align as they flow, creating a magnetic field that will be channeled through the screw. Now take the loose ends of the wire and attach them to the opposite ends of the battery. Remember to always handle electricity under the supervision of an adult and always wearing the appropriate protective equipment, like gloves. Success! We've created an electromagnet! Magnetic fields are important because they are everywhere. Engineers and scientists use magnetic properties to develop products and services that we use every day. Magnets are used in things like pickups and an electric guitar. The strip on the back of credit cards is composed of tiny magnetized particles that allow us to store information. There are even high-speed trains that levitate above the rails using electromagnets. We hope this introduction to electrons and magnetic fields has ignited your curiosity. Stay curious and have fun!